Hey guys, I'm going to be showing you all the advanced and mechanical assembly mates within SolidWorks. To start off, we're going to head to this track here. Now we want these wheels to move centered along this track, and we're going to do that using the width mate. Now we go back up, and we want to select the references that the faces are going to be centered by. And then the tab selections, which are the faces that are being centered. And when you select those, it centers the wheel. And we're going to do the same for the other one. And there we go. Now we want these wheels to move along the track. And to do that, we're just going to do a standard tangent mate with this face here and this one here. That's good, and do the same for the other. Now the wheels will always move along the track. Now what we're going to do with them is we're going to go back to the advanced mates, and we're going to do a symmetric mate. Now you have to select a symmetry plane, which is this plane here that I've already pre-created, and then the faces that you want to be made symmetric. Now, it wasn't noticeable, but a mate was just created. And when we move these, they move symmetrically to each other. Now I'm just going to go back down and delete that, because it's not useful for the other mate I'm going to show you. So I'm going to move those like this. Go back to the mates. We don't want this face selected. We're going to go into the advanced mates yet again. Go to the linear coupler. Now for this, you just need to select two portions here. For this, we're going to do this one and this one. And then if you scroll down, it has a ratio. So basically, for every 1 inch the blue face moves, the purple moves 1. We want it to move 2 inches for every one. So set it like that, and click OK. And now you can see that for every 1 inch, the other one moves 2. And then I believe the last thing I need to do with this setup here is just check out of this. Hold Control, and then you can just drag parts off of it, and when you let go, it creates another part, and we're just going to do a simple profile center with this. I'm sure you've all used this before, but I'm just going to go over it for the sake of covering all of them. So you select this face here, and the bottom one here, and it centers it. Now that's it for this track. We're going to head over here and show you the path mate. So we have this ball and this tube, and what we want is for this ball to travel through the tube. So we have to go in and show the sketch that we used to create the tube. Go back out and show it for the ball as well. Now what the path mate does is it mates a vertex to a path, and we want to mate this middle vertex to the path so that it travels through and the ball never leaves the tube. It always stays inside. So yet again, back to advanced mates. We hit the path mate, and like I previously said, you need a path selection, which is the path here, and then the component's vertex, and it mates it coincidentally, and then you can drag the ball through the tube. Always forget this, but you can't do that if you're in mates, so close out of it, and now you can drag it about the tube. You can see by the sketch that it is moving through the tube. And now, last thing we're going to do in advanced mates is I want to do a... Okay, that is fixed still. I want to do a limit distance mate. So, what we're going to do is head over to advanced mates and use the limiting distance one. We're going to set the maximum distance to 7 inches. I know that from redoing all of these assemblies. And we want it between this face and this face. And what that's going to do is it won't let this face go past 0 inches, but it won't let it extend more than 7. And that will always mean that this cannot go past the faces, so it doesn't collide with the inner piece here. We're not going to go over the limit angle one because it's self-explanatory. It's the same as this. It's just using angles. So we're going to click OK. And we're going to head over here and just do the screw mate. To do this, you have to show the hidden axis that they're on, and we're going to head into now the mechanical mates. We're going to click screw, And what you want in a screw is you want the hidden axis here mated with the one on the inside. And that creates a mate that when you drag this, it will also rotate down. So if I click out and go around, you can see that it screws down as if it was a regular bolt. And you can also set a limit distance mate so that wouldn't go through the face, etc. But for the simplicity of showing all the mates, I'm going to ignore that. We're going to head over here and do a hinge mate. So I have this here, and I want this to rotate about this hinge here. We go back down to the mechanical mates. Select hinge. And again, we need to select the hidden axis for the concentric. And for coincident, we need this top face. I can get it. There we go. With this face here. And what that does is allows it to freely rotate about the thing. You can add angle limits so that, say, there was a post sticking up here, it wouldn't travel through that post at that angle limit. So, but for this example here, there is no angle limit, so we just ignore that because it's a free moving hinge sort of thing. The last thing before I head over to the lovely gear setup is we're going to do some slot mates. So what I have here are some curved slots on the happy face pieces here. And, oh, I'm already pre-selecting something, so I can't. Okay, here we go. Now, in slot mates, you can have a free, a center in slot, a distance along the slot, or percent along slot. And what that's basically saying is it's defining where the slot is mated to the other one. You can also mate axes to slots, which I'll be showing later with this bolt. And you can also mate, I think, just like other circles in general, not just slots in themselves. So like you could put like washers on it and have it on the inside of the washer. But for this, we want to mate this slot to this one. You do so just by clicking the inside faces. Now this will drag about the slot in any way, and if you update it too quickly, SolidWorks has trouble updating the math, so it lags a little bit. Then we're going to do the same thing with this bolt and here, and that was just selecting the hidden axis like before. You check that, and we're going to do it one last time with the inner one. So now they all move together. Oh, whoops. Slot mate. There we go. So now, when you update this, they will all move together. The one happy face can move around, and the other one, the bolt can slide through. This one here is fixed, so that one's not going to move ever. Otherwise, this would be like really, really laggy when it updates. Now, the last thing we're going to do is head over to this gear assembly that I've set up. And we're going to do a gear mate for... I can get rid of the hidden axis now. A gear mate for here and just here. There we go. Now with gear mates, it will auto set a ratio based on the size of the things you're selecting. In this case, we don't really need to change them, I don't think, for any of these other than maybe a couple, and I'll be showing that later. You can reverse direction, but for this we don't want them reversed. We can check that. Before we keep doing more gear mates, I need to do a standard coincident mate with the bottom face. And this one here. So now that's always on the thing there. Now we go back in and do some more gear mates. I'm going to check this off beforehand, just because I had a lot of mates there. Now, we got gear mates for this center circle and the outer circle. Now, it's better if you select the outer circle first, that way it makes it easier to select the other one, which I should have done, but I didn't. And for now, I'm just going to let SolidWorks auto-determine whether or not the direction should be reversed or not, and if they're wrong afterwards, like the assumption's incorrect, we can just edit them and then unreverse them. So I'm just going to fly through and do all the gear mates. Try and get them done as quickly as possible for the sake of the tutorial. I always do this. You gotta select your mate. There we go. Now you want it with this and this. Gear mate. We want to set a gear mate for the cam as well. So for this and this. Gear mate. And then another one. For this here. And this here. Hoping I get all these right on the first try, because I'm trying to remember them all from memory. And then we want this. And this, I believe. Let me select you, please. There. And we want a gear mate. There. Now I think that should be good. The next one we're going to do is a rack and pinion. So as you see up top, we have a rack going through the gear here. We have it auto set up and it's colliding at the moment. But what I'm going to do is select this as the rack, and then the pinion would be the inner part of this gear. Through trial and error, I found that we need to set the pinion pitch diameter to be 3 inches. And that's auto going to move it. Now you can really look. This is just barely touching, and that's what you want. You can put collision detection on. There's no real need to. It's more or less just like when you want to show the example, all you need is to actually like have it look like it's hitting properly, even though it's maybe missing it by very small, minute measurements. Anyway, we're going to add that. And I think everything's good to go other than this cam follower. So what we're going to do now is go into the cam mate. And for the cam mate, all you have to do is pick the path, which is the outside face of this, and then the follower, which is going to be the vertex of this piece here. And that will always make it coincident to this face, no matter where its position is. So you can see as it updates, this piece will move. And now we just check to see that everything rotates properly. I'm assuming it probably won't, because that's how it seems to go when I do this. Think maybe those gears, nope, they're turning properly. Oh, okay, yeah, these ones here, if you look closely, they aren't turning in the same way that they should, so that one shouldn't be reversed. So if we scroll down and go to the mate, is it this one? I believe it's this one. Yeah, this one here. We edit this and unreverse that. Then I believe everything should be rotating properly. Yep. Only thing is maybe that smiley face here is going in the wrong direction. Personally, I don't really care. It was just more or less to show everyone all the mates. And like I said before, universal joint, I didn't feel it was that useful for this tutorial because it's not something I feel like we're going to use. And same with the limit angle. But yeah, that's the tutorial. Thanks for watching.